in here. If you did, if you don't remember, so you could have done it, right?
Absolutely.
Okay, if you did, had you ever done it before?
I don't recall if I ever used that word before. Have I admonished lawyers?
Would you agree with me that you would remember if you admonished somebody giving signals to a witness on the stand?
Signals.
Coaching them, signals to a witness.
Maybe.
There are times that would have happened and you wouldn't remember that?
There are times when, as a sitting judge, you see behavioral lawyer, and I could misinterpret it or not, but if I ever think that that's what's going on, then I would admonish the lawyer, yes. Would I use that word, counselor? I don't know.
Did you ever indicate on the bench, in regard to this case, concerning a 209A that was issued ex parte, did you ever make a statement in your court that you were contemplating reporting what this nominee did to the BBO?
What this nominee?
Regarding the 209A that had been issued ex parte in the district court and then was appealed, the 10-day appeal came to you in the probate court.
Well,
and you had a hearing on this.
That's not what would have happened because that's not the process. You can't do it that way. It would have been either initiated in the probate court and staying in the probate court, but it doesn't go from just court to probate court. So
do you remember having any kind of a 209A hearing in your court regarding an allegation by one of the parties that Mr. Hafner had it done and a 209A was issued because the wife felt in fear?
I remember there was a 209A. I don't remember the facts and circumstances of it.
Do you recall saying that you were contemplating reporting this attorney to the BBO?
No.
No. Do you recall giving Mr. Hafner, at the request of his lawyer, ordering that the 209A be dismissed?
Do I recall doing that? No. Could I have done it? Absolutely.
And you ordered legal fees in the amount of about $20,000 to be paid by this nominee's client?
No, I think what happened, maybe, was there was an agreement entered into between the parties relative to attorney's fees. But I don't recall having a hearing on attorney's fees at all. And if I dismissed...
So the parties went out, you told them to go out and come to an agreement. They came to an agreement that the nominee's client was to pay a certain amount of legal fees, and then that agreement was signed off on by you, right?
It would have been. Okay. It wouldn't have been on the 209A if that was dismissed, though. Or the library was a temporary order entered in the underlying divorce matter.
You recall being asked to expunge the record under 209A?
Yeah, I was asked to expunge the record, yeah.
And you said that you couldn't do it?
No, I probably didn't say I couldn't do it. I probably said there was a process for it, that they had to follow the appropriate process, including notifying probation.
And you were in agreement that it should be expunged?
I think we had a hearing on it. I'm not sure if they came to an agreement on expungement, but we would have had to have scheduled a hearing. Department of Probation would have had notice. If they didn't appear, the parties might have come to an agreement on it. I'm not sure. And if not, it would have been heard and I would have created an order. But I don't know. I haven't seen this in so long, I don't know.
So would you be able to get that docket to us here for our consideration and your findings?
Absolutely not.
Why, is that a private record?
Yes. No, an expunged record. I don't have control.
I'm talking about your findings in this case.
Oh, my findings?
Yeah.
My findings not the 209A, but my findings would have been in the underlying matter. They are a matter of public record. I'm not sure I can make anything happen.
So, would you be able to get the
cards up today. And also would provide copies to all the counselors.
Okay.
Which basically says that the litigant is litigious to the person.
Well, I don't know the man, but I did speak to him. He said to me that he filed one contempt action against his ex-wife and there was 154 counts to it. You allowed that contempt to be found for him. Remember that?
I remember at least probably two contempts that were filed.
And there was one contempt filed by his ex-wife and you denied her contempt on that. You found for her.
Okay. I don't know. Okay. If that's what the record says.
So, over a 2-year, multi-million dollar case, I know it was contentious, but that doesn't sound like a lot of litigation. A couple of contempts, one on each side, right?
I would have to look at the file.
No. For that size case, just two contempts over 2 years.
I think you're looking at it too narrowly. What really tells you whether or not it's contentious and litigious is the number of documentaries. And I couldn't tell you how many documentaries there were.
He tells me you never ruled against him on a contempt. You ruled in his favor on the 209A and it was dismissed by you. You made statements that the record should be expunged. About that?
No.
And you indicated on the record that you were thinking of reporting this nominee to the PTO or
this nominee? No.
Or getting a ex parte 209A when the nominee and Mister's lawyer work out of the same building and didn't support without notifying anybody he did it.
I've never ever thought I would report this nominee to the PTO ever.
So you would have never made a statement on record that you were contemplating?
Reporting this nominee to the PTO? Yep. No, I would never have made that statement on the record. Off the record to anyone. No.
So you can remember that you didn't do that?
I remember, I've never once reported an attorney to the PTO. I remember that.
I didn't say we're going to report, you said we're going to contemplate it, and the parties should go outside, get this expungement and costs for legal fees.
No.
Talk about
this nominee.
No question
in my mind.
For the record, I just asked to be passed out copies of Judge Hyland's findings from December 16th. That's the date that I believe was filed in the registry of probate. Actually, I think it was January 3rd, 2016. No quote took back to December 6th, 2016. And if you look through there, gives you,
so it's a year and a half ago.
A broad, much broader.
January 18th.
This is 2017. So December,
January 2016.
January 2017.
That's not. That would be more recent than that.
That is correct. And this matter actually started in March of 2015. 2015. Right. So, do you want to suspend on your questions to have a chance to read that?
Well, I see that we did in this order anyway. Order $15,000 for the husband's attorneys for legal fees.
back to $45,000 on this consent.
Why, Brad? I think lawyers ask for something to get less, right?
It's a process we're using.
Point of the matter is, you found for the husband, and you gave his attorney's legal fees, amount $15,000, which by the way, which by, was an agreement theory, wasn't it?
It was not an agreement, not talking about the Stevens.
Okay, this is a divorce?
No, it's, this is substantive divorce, this is a much more recent matter. That's why I asked about the dates, this is something that recently occurred. And this is a recent subsequent fee.
Okay.
And decision.
And what was your decision in this case?
I think you haven't had it yet.
I can't read, what did you say?
It's just a finding in his favor, and his attorney fees. I can't say anything more than the public record shows.
How many did everybody get that? I think there are others recording, but I don't think that it was. I should have.
Do we have a play that you want to? Let me see that. Turn my video on, I guess. Is that it?
Okay, you bring that.
We'll bring it over here.
Start it over there. Catch you.
Which way do you get all passed?
Start it over.
I
So, do you recall that?
That's me on the record.
Do you recall saying that?
Do I recall saying that? No. Did I just hear the report and now recall it? Yes. Okay.
So, Councilor Ionella said to you that what was done in front of you was total, was inappropriate. You would agree with that?
I would agree that I don't tolerate any.
No. Okay. My question is, you agree that what was done was inappropriate in front of you?
I agree that that was my perception at the time.
No.
That I believed it, that yes, Councilor, I believed it to be inappropriate at the time.
You said on the tape it was inappropriate. Totally inappropriate is what you said.
Correct.
And I know you don't lie on the stand, do you? You do not lie on the stand.
If you're asking me if
no,
I lie,
no, I'm
I find
saying
that
you don't.
Because
I'm not saying that. I'm saying you do not, as a judge, lie on the stand. You make a comment to somebody in
the
judge
bench.
On the bench. You mean
it. I do mean it, yes.
So you meant what was done was totally inappropriate.
I mean, I find any of that behavior of shaking heads inappropriate in the courtroom, yes.
Okay. Now, you accepted an apology from the other lawyer in the mail.
It was two emails, but yeah, the other
one. I did not hear an apology from this nominee on
if
that
you
tape.
Listen to the tape, and I don't remember this specifically, he said, I said, no shaking heads, turn cash, or you either turn him in, which makes me believe at this point that I saw turn cash shaking head. And when I saw that, I was admonishing the team of lawyers, saying, no shaking heads, turn cash, and you either turn random. Sounds like I didn't see that. I saw Attorney Patch doing it. Attorney Patch got up. She apologized. I accepted it and moved on.
Well, she didn't apologize at first. She first denied it, right? She said, I wasn't doing that. I was looking at some papers, and you said you weren't. You were certainly new.
That's right.
She was not telling you the truth.
I did not make that assessment, no.
Well, you knew you didn't agree with her saying
I
was just
agree.
Looking at papers. She
that's
was
correct.
Doing something else with the witness.
I agree that that's what I saw, and I needed her to move on from that.
Right. She said, then I want to apologize to her.
Correct.
But no apology came from this nominee.
I have to believe this nominee wasn't shaking
no.
her head.
You want to play the tape again? You said it was.
No, I did not say that.
Let's listen to it again.
All right, we're going to move on.
No,
this is the last time we're
hearing
the tape.
I am not done yet. Both of them were shaking their heads.
I would not say that.
Wait a minute, he's saying to Clutch.
No,
excuse me. I'm out of order. Counselor Drudo.
Okay. Would you agree with me that is serious conduct?
That what is serious conduct?
What we've just been discussing and what you would admonish.
I know.
I've probably done it myself a few times over the years. But do you think it's inappropriate behavior?
It's behavior admonishing? Yes.
Your answer, yes, it's inappropriate behavior. So when we heard from, I think one of the witnesses said that she wrote the rules on the forum. Do you agree with that?
What I did is she wrote the rules.
No. I mean, you used it as a metaphor. Do you think that kind of conduct is important to follow?
I think you're taking a very narrow view of one is. This is a person I've known 30 years.
Well, I'm gonna look at the tape, get the tape about 209A, and see if it says on that that you made a comment about contemplating. I'm going to see if that was said. that wasn't said at the 9/8. That was said, that was at a different hearing. So that would be twice.
There were numerous hearings.
You would agree with me that if that was ever said on the record, that's two instances of concern for us.
That wasn't said. Yes.
We would agree. All right, thank you.
Councilman.
Thank you, Councilor. First of all, Judge, you said that it was so long ago, you couldn't remember, it was 2 years ago. It actually was 2006.
It was not being asked for.
Well, it says on this document, December 2016. I know that. And also, I talked with this person, and I just want to say, first of all, in all due respect, the district council scheduled this hearing for a week. And Ms. Mina, okay, Mr. Hefner, went to court on another matter, filed something. He saw this posted on the board in court that their hearing was going to be today. And when he spawned, it said July 23rd, I don't know what that meant. So he said in a letter to me that, he said, first of all, I found out the day before, and he says, and I went on a business trip. And the other thing is, it said to reply a month after the hearing. So, okay, let that aside. First of all, I wrote down what I heard on the recording. I have other recordings about the 209A and everything, but I didn't want to bring all of that in. Right now, I'm about ethics. We're not talking about the qualifications, experience of the nominee. I'm talking about ethics. And I've talked to many lawyers, and no lawyer has told me that they ever have nodded their head and signaled to their client, signaled the witness. And what happened here, you raised your voice at Attorney Randall and at this contempt hearing in 2016, and Attorney Randall is representing the client, Carolyn Hefner. My colleague here has a lot of things that I would say, so I'm going to try to break it down. Okay, the tape recorder that we have is the witness, Carolyn Hefner, on the witness stand. Attorney Randall is signaling this witness as her assistant, Attorney Koch, is doing as well. You are presiding, you raise your voice, you stop the proceedings, and you reprimanded Attorney Randall and told her to stop signaling the witness. In response, Attorney Koch made a face. And you reprimanded to her, get rid of that face. Okay? So, this is about ethics. And she's your personal friend for 30 years. This is very difficult for you, but you have to separate this, okay? And to me, it's egregious when you have spoken out, you raised your voice, and reprimanded her. And you're coming here and telling us to put her on a bench as a judge. I can't even believe why you're here, in all due respect. And
sir, question, Counselor Devaney.
And I will tell you something. I will tell you something. Why you've got a call last night. Because yesterday afternoon, I tried to see the governor. He was out. He was not here. I wrote him a letter and asked him to withdraw this nominee. I didn't want this to be a public forum to do this. Just do it. I can't imagine, and I talked to so many ways, no lawyers do that, not heads and gesture. And you know what? As a lay person, maybe a certain gesture means something, maybe another one means another. This is not right. And you know what? You had a responsibility to report that to the BBO, and you didn't, because this is a personal friend. This is where personal friendship is really,
Question debate. Is there a question?
I'm asking you, in this contempt hearing, you said it was a long time ago, you couldn't remember, and it really wasn't that long ago. And are you saying that you don't remember
Now, when it's to the tape, does that refresh my recollection?
Sure, of course. If it wasn't a crime of 30 years, would you have been able to stick with it?
I was very quiet. Ellen Randall is a colleague, former colleague, and associate, but a friend of 30 years. Friends. It's not that I don't know this woman, I practice at the same time as her. We had many cases together. I've never met her family until today.
But you have a mutual respect over 30 years, obviously. So it isn't like this is a attorney that you don't know.
Correct.
And can I ask you if that was an attorney you didn't know, and they this misconduct was going on, signaling the witness and your colleague maybe faces, you would not, would you have recorded?
So the signaling the witness is your word.
No, it's on the tape. Please don't change.
I didn't hear signaling the witness.
Yes. Yes.
I didn't hear signaling the witness.
Well,
you said I'm shaking your head, but I didn't hear signaling the witness. Well, I'm sorry, counselor, I didn't hear that. And I just listened to the tape.
Is signaling the same as lying to a witness?
No,
is giving a message?
No. You're using a word that I didn't use. Well, you said, don't nod your heads. And if you want to put that interpretation on, it's you meant. But I said, don't nod your heads. And I called it to the attention of the attorney class first, which leads me to believe, although I have no current recollection of what happened.
It was second if you're going to take those consequences.
No,
she made a face after you said that.
I called it to the attention of the attorney class first, and then I had it as co-counsel.
You know, I'll give you a copy of that tape. I have also other tape recordings of that procedure and the 209, but I just didn't think I wanted to bring all that in. I didn't think it was appropriate. I think what I'm saying is that I've been here 18 years and I've never heard of a nominee who's going after a judgeship who has interfered with the normal process of hearing and nodding and doing all this to signal. She was signaling her client, okay? And I've never seen that before. And then, to me, it was so egregious that you were the judge that spoke up and you reprimanded her, and you're here saying this person should be a judge. I don't get it. I just don't. And my colleague, we have been long since we've been here 30 years, we've never heard it. We've never heard this before. And it's not acceptable. It's not acceptable. And I just can't believe that you can't believe, you can't remember what it was. It's so long ago. Is 6 months so long ago? I don't think so.
I preside over 3,500 filings.
But how many of you represent me?
I'm not. That was a question earlier, and I can't tell you the number. But I run a very tight bookroom, and it doesn't matter who's appearing before me, whether it's an attorney I don't know, whether it's an attorney from out of our area, it doesn't matter. In hearing, I might accept that totally if it's a busy motion session, but if it's a hearing and there's a witness on the scene, no, I can't accept that.
Well, I'll tell you, I don't do this for this to pass the government. I have in my head qualified and experience. This is all about this. And this is about the new conduct. You failed to report that complaint because of the relationship.
If I reported every nod of the head, every roll of the eye,
it's not the nod of the head, it's signaling my client. Notice, I'm done. I actually counseled Drew and Bill covered everything that I was going to say, but I can produce other recordings if you want. Those are actually from the court. They're from the court. I didn't make them up.
Okay. Thank you. All right. Councilor Ferraro?
Judge, thanks for being here today. Sorry I was late. I was talking to someone else from the 401 Bay Area. But
you didn't miss anything.
Yeah. Well, I'm trying to pick up on the tail ends here. I'm trying to get caught up. I was a police officer for 30 years. I've been a lawyer for 24 years. I've seen a lot of head nodding. Sometimes you might be agreeing to what the person is saying on the stand, not necessarily coaching them or signaling them. So I'm sorry that I missed it. How many years have you been on the bench?
6.5.
And how many of you say the 35 point hearings, motion trials a year?
New filings a year, that's including whatever's in the process. I've decided maybe 40 motions, 50 motions, each
see a lot of head nodding overall. Not signaling, but head nodding. And I'm sure you're aware, you're fully aware of your obligation to the courts of this
community. Would be unethical not.
Yes. And have you ever reported any orders to the
community? Not.
Have you ever sought fit to report any orders to the community?
I have not.
And if you sought fit, would you have done it?
Of course.
Without reservation?
Without reservation.
And how long have you known the nominee?
30 years.
And how many interactions have you had with her over the years in the court setting?
It's hard to say. I practiced for 27 years before I took the bench. For 27 years, we had cases on and off. We both did probate the family. She did it more than I did it, but we probate the family over that period of time.
Dozens, hundreds?
Probably dozens.
Is it fair to say that when you were on the bench, you may have nodded your head yes or no? Maybe not even thinking about it. Agreeing or not agreeing with what is being said.
I hate to say something, but it probably happens.
Have you ever seen any other behavior from the nominee that would lead you to admonish what they were?
No, I find them dedicated, compassionate, hardworking, ethical.
And do you know where I understand I went through a divorce happened in my proceeding. I understand when people are frustrated with your husband or your wife. But beyond this one allegation that someone nodded their head one day, is there anything else about the nominee you've heard negative?
No. She's very well respected by not just her peers, but other judges in the West.
Great. Anyone else?
Thank you, Judge. Sorry.
I get to ask questions.
I still say thank you, though. Yeah.
Yes, you absolutely.
Sorry, you had to go through all
that. All right, I'm going to direct your attention, first of all, to your findings dated January 17th, January 3rd, 2017. I'd like the counselor, who just finished questioning before Counselor Ferraro, to listen to what her findings were. And you'll have a chance to read.